This is part two of completing the squares, and we're solving quadratic equations using this technique, and we do the following three problems on this video. This is part two of completing the square. In part one, we showed how to take a binomial like x squared plus 6x and add something to it to make it a perfect square trinomial. Now we're going to use that to solve quadratic equations. Alright, so we're going to take this problem, x squared plus 6x equals negative 8. And here's the technique. We want to write the x squared and the x term on one side of the equation, and actually notice it is on one side of the equation, but we want to know what we can add to that side to make it a perfect square. Now this is an equation, so if we add something to the left side of the equal sign, we must add it to the right side of the equal sign. So our first step is to write the x squared term and the x term on one side plus a blank, and then write the constant term on the other side plus some other blank. Now we want to complete the square. So what will this be? If this were a perfect square, and again we did this in the last video, this would have to be an x to get our x squared. Plus sign for the middle term means it's going to be a plus sign here. And then we want half of the coefficient. So we want half of 6, which will be 3. Now we take the 3 and square it to get what goes up here. Right? See, you can see that 3 squared. Well, if you add 9 to this side of the equation, you add 9 to the other side of the equation. Notice what I do. I go down and figure out the binomial first, and then I go back and fill in the blank. I think that's easier than trying to figure out the 9 and then going back and backwards and putting a 3. So we have negative 8 plus 9. What does that equal? That's 1. All right, now we're going to go back to, before we learned how to complete the square, taking the square root of both sides of an equation. So we're going to use the square root property. So if you want to show it, you could just put a square root around both sides, because now you're taking the square root of something squared. But be careful here. Remember, when you do this, you have to put plus or minus in front of the square root on the other side. Once you take it out of this square root, right, and you're just going to write x plus 3, we're going to have plus or minus. Now what's the square root of 1? That's 1. This gives us two separate equations. X plus 3 equals 1, or x plus 3 equals negative 1. So now we can solve those by subtracting 3 from both sides. X equals negative 2, and also the other equation we get x equals negative 4. We've got two solutions, negative 2 and 4, sorry, negative 4, to the original equation, x squared plus 6x equals negative 8. Now I'm going to leave that to you to check. You would first check negative 2 by plugging that in for x and making sure this equation is true, both sides are the same number, and then you would check negative 4. Okay, now, notice that my answer here, there were no square roots involved. That means that that problem could have been done by factoring. So let's just take the same problem, x squared plus 6x equals negative 8. And see if we could have done this a different way by factoring. Remember, what you do is you set the equation equal to 0, factor the left-hand side, if that's where the quadratic is. Set each factor equal to 0 and solve each equation. Notice negative 4. Notice I get exactly the same answer. So I didn't need to use completing the square, but I could, and I wanted to complete the square on a simple problem first. This is a problem that you could have gotten the answer by factoring, or you could have done it by completing the square. But in both cases, the answer is you've got two possible solutions, negative 2 or negative 4. Let's try another problem. All right, so here's a problem. X squared minus 6x equals 1. Well, you could try factoring it. So what you would do is set the equation equal to 0 and see if you could factor. and you get stuck right here. You can't factor that. So this is why we have to know how to complete the square. It's another way of doing it to get the answer. All right, so what do? We put the x squared term and the x term on one side of the equation, put a big blank. You can put a blank or a box, whatever you like. And then I already have the constant on the right-hand side, and I'm going to have to add the same thing to both sides. So I'm going to come down and say, well, if this was a perfect square trinomial, what would be in here? What would it have to be? Well, to get the x squared, that'll be an x. And we've got a minus sign, and then half of what 6 is, which is 3. So what am I going to have to add to both sides? 3 squared. You're always adding a positive number. Okay, so 1 plus 9, right? I don't have a 1 over here anymore. Remember, you have to add 9 to both sides so that this equation, it's still a true equation, equals 10. Now I can use the square root property by taking the square root of both sides. And when you do that, as soon as you take the square root on this left-hand side, you absolutely must remember to put plus or minus in front of that square root of 10. Now, you can't simplify square root of 10, so you just have to leave it like that, square root of 10. And I can just add 3 to both sides, and remember we write that in front of the plus or minus. That's the standard way. So we've got two solutions. 3 plus the square root of 10 is one solution, and 3 minus the square root of 10 is the other solution. Now, these can be checked. I'll go ahead and check one of them. How about I check 3 plus square root of 10? It's actually harder to check than just do the problem over, but let's do it. We're going to put in 3 plus square root of 10 for x. So I need to put in place of x here, 3 plus square root of 10 squared minus 6 times 3 plus square root of 10. Now I have to square this. Remember, that's 3 plus square root of 10 times 3 plus square root of 10. You could write that out and do the FOIL method, and you'll get 9 plus 3 square root of 10 plus another 3 square root of 10 plus square root of 10 squared will give you 10. I'm going to have to also distribute my minus sign here. My minus 6 times 3 is minus 18, and minus 6 square root of 10. Okay, so just keep in mind, this is what you get when you square 3 plus square root of 10. Don't write just 9 plus 10, they're those middle terms. All right, so if I add like terms here, and I notice I get 9 plus 10, that's 19 minus 18, so that gives me 1. And then I have 3 square root of 10 plus 3 square root of 10, that's 6 square root of 10, minus a 6 square root of 10. Ah, so it simplifies to 1. That's what I have on the other side, and it checks. I'm sure most people aren't going to check their answer, but that's the only way you know for sure you got it right. So our solutions right here are correct. Actually, all I know for sure is 3 plus square root of 10. But they're conjugates, and that will happen if you have any square roots. Okay, let's do one more problem. Okay, we're going to solve this by completing the square. By the way, note that it does not factor. So, I put the x squared and the x term on one side, plus a blank, and we put this constant, this plus 2 on the other side, will be negative 2, plus a blank. And we come down and write down what would be in the parentheses if it were a perfect square. We'd have the x minus half of 2 is 1, and then 1 squared is 1. So 1 gets added to both sides. So I have x minus 1 squared equals, on the other side I have negative 2 plus 1, which is negative 1. All right, now I'm going to take the square root of both sides. So I have what's inside, it'll just be the x minus 1, and remember to put plus or minus. Now, what's the square root of negative 1? That's I, remember our friend I. So finally, just add 1 to both sides, you get x equals 1 plus or minus I. So there are two solutions to this one. 1 plus I and 1 minus I. And I'll leave the check to you. You could go plug in one of these into the X and make sure that's good practice on squaring with complex numbers, etc. We're going to do a lot more problems because there's a lot more to this. We might have a coefficient of like 3, which changes everything. So make sure you look at the rest of the videos on completing the square.